I want all of us to arise.
Ningalipenda sote tusimame.
And welcome the bishop.
Na tumkaribishe askofu.
Come on, appreciate the bishop.
Tafadhali mkaribishe askofu.
I'll stand here until he comes. I welcome him.
Nitasimama haji aje nimkaribishe.
Amen.
Amen.
Oh, what a welcome.
Karibuni
sana. Let's appreciate Alice.
Tumshukuru sana.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Jina la Bwana libarikiwe.
Actually, she was right. You look sharp.
Ni kweli kwa hakika unakaa.
Tell your neighbor you look wow.
Mwambie jirani yako unakaa wow.
You look sharp.
Unakaa poa.
You remember one time we were taught this by somebody from South Africa.
Wakati mmoja tukafunzwa hivi kutoka na mtu kutoka.
You look good.
Ya kwamba unakaa vizuri.
And then you say thank you.
Na unasema asante.
And finally you say I know.
Na unasema ninajua.
Let's try it one more time.
Wacha tufanye hivyo tena.
You look good.
Mwakaa vema.
Thank you.
Asante. Ninajua.
And then I
ninajua.
Know. Let's do it one more time.
Tufanye
you look good.
Mwakaa vema.
Thank you.
Asante.
I know.
Ninajua.
Let's get seated in the presence of the
Lord.
We are so grateful for what God is doing among us.
Tunashukuru kile Mungu atenda miongoni mwetu.
Let's appreciate Daktari Kiroko.
Wacha tumshukuru, tumshangilie Daktari Abu Kiroko.
For the interpretation.
Kwa sababu ya kutafsiri.
He is doing very well.
Anafanya vema sana.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Jina la Bwana libarikiwe.
You see, the preachers for this conference are already here.
Wahubiri wa kongamano hili wako hapa tayari.
We have our brother Bishop Ilumba from all the way in Tabora.
Ndugu yetu Rumba kutoka pale Tabora.
A man I really honor. He's a man I really honor.
Nina mtumishi ninayemheshimu sana.
Because Tabora is not Arusha.
Sababu Tabora sio Arusha.
When you get to Arusha, you still have a longer distance than from Nairobi to Arusha.
Ukienda Arusha bado utakuwa na safari nyingine ndefu kutoka pale.
We that have gone there, the Imani choir. I think they went until they went.
Walienda hadi wakaenda.
But finally they got there.
Alafu wakafika.
We really appreciate this team.
Kwa hivyo tunawashukuru sana wapendwa hawa.
Pastor, you're welcome for traveling with the bishop.
Mchungaji, asante kwa kukaribu sana kwa kusafiri
nasi. Bless you so much.
Mungu akubariki.
I know we will give him time later on.
Tutakupatia nafasi.
So that they can greet us.
Ili kwamba mtusalimie.
The group from Nyeri and Thika in Nairobi, because that group is from Nyeri, Thika, Nairobi.
Kuna wa Nyeri, wa Thika, wa Nairobi.
The churches that are Bishop Kamere and Emily are involved.
Kanisa ambazo Askofu Kamere wanahusika.
We want actually to appreciate your coming.
Tunataka sana kushukuru kuja kwenu.
I'm already challenged.
Nimewekwa changamoto tayari.
Your conference next year.
Kongamano lenyu mwaka ujao.
No promises.
Sitaweka.
No promises.
Siweki ahadi.
But if we are going to send Leah again, she will come with many others.
Lakini kama tutatuma Leah pia atakuja na wengine.
Blessed be the name of the
Jina
Lord.
Jina la Bwana libarikiwe.
And then we have Bishop Robert.
Alafu tuko na Askofu Robert.
Bishop Robert and Leah are my friends.
Askofu Robert na Leah ni rafiki zangu.
Just like Jacob and Emily are my friends.
Kama vile Yakobo na Emily ni rafiki zangu.
But these are very close because they are here in Ruiru.
Hawa ni wa karibu sana sababu wako Ruiru.
They come from the Prevailing Word Church.
Wanakuja kutoka katika neno liendelealo kanisa.
Let's appreciate the bishop here. From Prevailing Word. The Lord bless you all. But I have a supporter myself. And the DOI has a supporter. It is good for us to recognize. You know, when she comes to DOI, she comes herself and her daughter who is a pastor here. And her granddaughter.
Anakuja mwenyewe, anakuja na msichana wake na pia
mtu. It's normally very powerful.
Inakuwa jambo kuu sana.
Mwaroide vitu uko togeidie.
Karibu sana. Utusalimie tafadhali.
This is the mom to Beatrice Yukenake. Bring your mother.
Mamake Beatrice, mlete mama.
Beatrice is one of our pastors.
Beatrice ni mchungaji mmoja wetu.
And this lady comes from Nakuru every year.
Na anatoka Nakuru kila mwaka.
Actually, there are times she comes even for DOI, which meets once a month.
Anakuja wakati mwingine mkutano wa DOI karibu mwezi kila mwezi.
We bless the name of the Lord.
Tunabariki jina la Bwana.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Bwana asifiwe kanisa.
Amen.
Nawasalimu katika jina la Yesu.
Amen.
Majina yangu inaitwa Lucy Wanjiko. Na mimi ndiye mama ya Pastor Beatrice. Bwana asifiwe sana.
Amen.
Jioni njema, nimeokoka, Kristo ni Bwana. Amekuwa mwema tangu nilipomjua na ameendelea kuwa mwema. Bwana asifiwe sana.
Amen.
Kuna neno katika Yohana 15 mstari wa kwanza inasema, Bwana anasema yeye ndiye mzabibu wa kweli. Bwana asifiwe sana.
Amen.
Na baba yake ndiye mkulima. Anasema lile tawi ambalo halijashikanishwa na lile na ule mti litanyauka. Bwana asifiwe sana.
Amen.
Kwa hivyo moyo wangu hupenda, kwa sababu mimi ni lile taga, nataka nijishikanishe sana na ule mzabibu ndio niweze kuzaa. Sababu Bwana, Biblia inasema lile tawi ambalo halizazaa linakatwa na kutupwa nje, na likikauka linachomwa. Bwana asifiwe sana.
Amen.
Kwa hivyo moyo wangu hutamani sana kushikanishwa na ule mzabibu ndio niweze kuzaa. Bwana asifiwe sana. Sijui wewe jioni ya leo umeshikanishwa na nini. Bwana atusaidie sana, tuwe mbali, tushikanishwe na ule mzabibu ndio tuweze kuzaa. Na tukizaa matunda yale ambayo yanafurahisha Bwana, si tutafika mbinguni. Wapendwa, shabaha ni kufika mbinguni. Hata kama kuna mambo gani, hata ya gani, hata mazito, shabaha ni kufika mbinguni. Kwa hivyo ni tutafute Bwana kwa bidii. Bwana asifiwe sana. Mimi huja sababu mimi nataka kuokota wakati wa hali. Bwana asifiwe sana.
Amen.
Kwa sababu lile neno litanisaidia wakati wa shida. Bwana asifiwe sana. Kule Nakuru nashiriki katika kanisa la Wadi Waidi. Na mimi hupenda sana kuja hapa kila mwaka, kwa sababu hata wana wa Israeli walikuwa naenda Yerusalemu kila mwaka safari moja. Na kwa hakika walipoenda hawakutoka mahali pale vile walivyoingia. Na mwaka mzima wataendelea na ile chakula walikula mahali pale, na ile neno lilikuwa mahali pale. Na mimi hutaka kuongeza nikija hapa kwenu, nasikia nimeongezwa hata imefurika.
Amen.
Naweza kutembea mwaka mzima. Bwana asifiwe sana. Bwana wa mzima awabariki.
Amen.
Amen. Bwana Yesu apewe sifa.
Amen.
Si hicho Kiswahili ni kizuri sana.
Chema Kiswahili kile.
Sasa muulize jirani yako, kwa nini wewe uongeaye Kiswahili? Kuna shida gani? Ukitembea kanisa yetu mara moja, haukuagi mgeni tena. Kwa hivyo nataka kualika mshirika wetu mmoja ambaye anashiriki kanisa la Living Faith huko Nyeri, mshirika wetu mmoja anaitwa Mudhoni wa Kamere. Just come, let's all stand. Mudhoni will lead us into a chorus or two. Just come the way you are, because you're where. Hapa ni kwenu, hapa ni kwenu. Let's appreciate Mudhoni. And we'll ask these guys to be ready with these things so that we can all praise the Lord. I said to simame. Okay, All right.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
I would like to ask choir, please come and join me.
Choir, tafadhali.
And also my sister Olive.
Na dadangu Olive, tafadhali. Njoo.
You look sharp. You look great.
Wakusifiwa, wakuabudiwa, ni wewe tu, Mungu wa miungu. Wakusifiwa, wakuabudiwa, ni wewe.
Ni wewe tu Bwana,
ni wewe tu Bwana,
ni wewe
Zimbarikiwe sana.
Amen.
Hey, iyo ni moto wa kuotea mbali kidogo. Amen, amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Bwana sifiwe.
Now remember what we said in the morning. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Oh, let's teach the people that have visited
us. Watu wafunze wanaotutembelea.
We were talking about the power of praising God.
Tulikuwa tunaangalia kuhusu nguvu za kumsifu Mungu.
And we said as Jehoshaphat was going with the army.
Na kasema Yehoshaphat alipokuwa anaenda na lile jeshi.
They were saying praise the Lord.
Walikuwa wanasema Bwana sifiwe.
And the echo was
na ile sauti ilikuwa
for his mercies endureth forever. Let's do it one more time. Praise the Lord.
Bwana sifiwe. Rehema zake.
Let's do it one more time. Praise the Lord. And do us forever.
Whoa!
Blessed be the name of the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
We may get seated.
Tunaweza keti.
We want to declare this conference officially open.
Tunatangaza kwamba kongamano hili limefunguliwa kirasmi.
But before we do it. Just before we do it,
lakini kabla tufanye hivyo,
I want to share a thought or two, then we are going to declare it officially.
Nishiriki mawaidha mawili matatu, alafu tutaweza kuitangaza rasmi.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Jina la Bwana libarikiwe.
The whole year we have been talking about the manifestation of the kingdom of God.
Mwaka mzima tumekuwa tukiongea kuhusu udhihirisho wa ufalme wa Mungu.
The financial manifestation.
Udhihirisho wa kifedha.
Manifestation in our worship.
Udhihirisho katika kuabudu kwetu.
We have talked about so much in the manifestation in this church.
Tumekuwa tukiongea sana kuhusu udhihirisho.
But before we declare the conference open,
lakini kabla tujafungua kirasmi kongamano,
I want to share things that I think are important for you.
Nishiriki tu mambo ambayo nadhania ni muhimu kwako,
which will show you,
ambayo itakuonyesha,
because even you need to be manifested.
Kwa sababu hata wewe unastahili
kudhihirika. As the kingdom is being manifested,
ufalme unapodhihirika,
you also need to be manifested.
Pia wahitaji kudhihirika.
But for you to be manifested,
lakini ili udhihirike,
you need to know your season.
Wahitaji kujua muhula wako.
The sons of Issachar,
wana wa Isaka,
they knew their times.
Wakajua muda wao.
The people of Jerusalem,
watu wa Yerusalemu,
did not know their season.
Hawakujua muhula wao.
And there is lamentation.
Na wakawa wanalalamika.
But in the Old Testament,
lakini katika
the children of Issachar knew their season.
Walijua muda wao.
Blessed be the name of the
Lord. Jina la Bwana libarikiwe.
Once you know your season,
ukijua
muda wako, you are a blessed person.
Umebarikiwa.
You know, Kenya, we have only one season.
Kenya tuko tu na nyakati
moja. With an interruption of rain.
Ambayo inazumbuliwa tu na mvua.
But the countries that have seasons.
Lakini nchi ambazo ziko na mihula
ama nyakati. When you get there,
ukienda kule,
you can tell the season.
Unaweza ukajua
by the dressing how people dress.
Na vile watu wamevalia mavazi.
But in this country,
lakini katika nchi hii,
you will see me with a suit.
Utaniona na suti.
In January,
katika Januari,
and in December.
Hata December.
But in those countries,
lakini nchi zingine,
there are seasons,
kuna mihula,
that they don't wear a jacket,
ambao hawavai jaketi.
But if you saw someone with a kabuti,
lakini
during summer,
ukiona mtu amevaa kabuti,
that guy is going to burn with the heat.
Ni mtu anataka kupata joto.
Because at that time,
kwa sababu wakati ule,
you dress light.
Unavaa vile.
When you know your season,
ukijua muhula wako,
you are a blessed person.
Umebarikiwa.
You can angle yourself,
unaweza jiwekelea,
towards a direction
kuelekea,
that God can see you and that God can bless you.
Na atakubariki.
The biggest question that we need to ask ourselves,
swali kuu tujiulize,
ni what is my desire,
ni nini tamaa yangu,
in this time,
katika muhula huu,
and what is my season,
na ni nini nyakati yangu.
Because every person,
kwa sababu kila mtu,
whether you are in a ministry,
ukiwa katika huduma,
or you are in our church here,
ama uko kanisani,
or you are in business,
ama uko biashara,
you have a season,
uko na wakati,
that you need to be manifested,
ambao unahitaji kudhihirika.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Jina la Bwana
libarikiwe. And we normally tell the devil,
niambia shetani,
when you see me down,
ukiniona chini,
don't celebrate,
usikafurahi,
because it is only for a season, and God will lift me up.
Na Mungu ataniinua.
Look at your neighbor and ask neighbor, do you know your season?
Je, wajua wakati wako?
Do you know your season?
Wajua wakati wako?
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Jina la Bwana libarikiwe.
You know, don't sympathize with me, devil. Because one of these days, I'm going to arise and get into the position that God wants me to be in. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Francis.
Asante sana.
For making sure daktari anashika kitu.
Kwamba nikuwe na kitu.
Lakini bado hajapata moto. Simumwekee moto.
Niweke moto tafadhali.
Tafadhali mumwekee moto. Kama ni muimbaji akisema jaza moto. Yes. More power. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. So every person, every ministry, including Deliverance Church here, in ourselves, in our prayer groups, we need a season of God manifesting us so that we are manifested. Blessed be the name of the Lord. The Bible has told us that there is time for everything. This means there is a time for your manifestation. Tell your neighbor, there is a time for my manifestation, and there will be a time for your manifestation. It is a time when God will expose you. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. When we came to Zimmerman, nobody wanted to associate with us. The place we were to get a plot, they even said to one another, those are devil worshippers, don't give them place. So we struggled ourselves. But today, because God has manifested us, every plot they are selling in Zimmerman, they have first of all to ask us whether we want it. So we will buy all the houses around here in the name of the Lord, because we'll be exposed. Tell your neighbor, when I will be exposed, you will also know it. Tell them to look at you very well, because when you'll be exposed, they will know it. There is no exposing that is kidogo. When God exposes you, when God manifests you, you become like Washo.
Unakuwa kama Washo.
You become a son.
Unakuwa mwana.
Instead of being a daughter.
Badala ya kuwa mstari.
When God exposes you,
Mungu akikudhihirisha,
it doesn't matter whether you are number six.
Haijalishi wewe ni number six.
In your family,
katika familia,
God can turn you around.
Mungu anakutu.
And you become number one.
Na unakuwa number one.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Jina la Bwana libarikiwe.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Tell your neighbor.
Jirani.
This week,
wiki hii,
I'm getting into my season.
Ninaingia wakati
of being exposed.
Wa kufunuliwa.
In the mighty name of Jesus. It is a time when God can expose your ministry, pastor. When God can expose you, ministry team member. When God can expose you as a Christian in this church. It is a time when God can expose you in your business. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Oh, don't sympathize with me. I'm selling tomatoes today. But I will own a kiosk. And if I'm in a kiosk, don't sympathize with me. I'm moving to a shop. I've located it. And if I'm in a shop, don't sympathize with me. I am moving into a mini supermarket. And if I'm in a mini supermarket, don't sympathize with me. I'm going to a bigger supermarket. Blessed be the name of the Lord. God is going to expose me. May God expose you. May God remember you. May the Lord remember your business. Blessed be the name of the Lord. If there was one matatu, may the Lord give you three. May the Lord give you four. May the Lord give you six. May you become 2NK. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
God, it is a time when God makes you visible. Exposure is to make you visible. For a long time, nobody has even bothered. They even thought you will never make it. They even thought you are just a house guy. But there is a time that God wants to expose you. Because you are not useless. He died for you. He will expose you. And one of these days, they will say like what they told the blind Bartimaeus. They said, you know, the master is calling you. The same people who had told him, shut up. The master is calling you. May that time happen to you. That the same people who put you down will come and expose you in the name of Jesus.
Whoa.
I'm not a house help. I'm not a house help.
Mimi situ wa kusaidia kazi
ya nyumba. I'm a technician.
Mimi ni wa kushughulikia.
Who knows how to technify your food technically.
Ujuzi wa kutengeneza chakula.
And one of these days,
na siku moja,
I will have my own hotel.
Nitakuwa na hoteli yangu.
Yes.
Ndio.
Blessed be the name of
Jina
the Lord.
Jina la Bwana libarikiwe.
Whoa. Oh, God is good.
Oh, Mungu ni mwema.
You know, as I speak, I remember a brother who went into a company and they employed him there. I will not mention him because some of you know him. But he worked for only 6 months. Then he bought that company. He became the boss of that company. He was the only black. He is still the only black. But he has employed wazungus. I'm saying this to some of you. May the Lord expose you. You are an employee. You become an employer. Blessed be the name of the Lord. When your season comes, the Lord will lift you. It is a time when God unveils you. But there are 4 signs of this manifestation. And we are looking at the book of 2 Kings chapter 2 verse 1 to 14. Then we'll look at the 4 signs of manifestation that God is going to bring your way. And then we'll be done. We'll open this Congress conference officially. I can preach for 20 minutes or for 1 hour. So tell your neighbor, please relax. The pilot in charge is a qualified one. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Praise the Lord. His mercies endure forever. Because you want to encourage me. His mercies endure forever. Can you give us the scriptures if you can? Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Whoa. 2 Kings. Coming. Have faith, it is coming. They are just working on it. Hallelujah. Elijah said to Elisha, stay here. The Lord has sent me to Bethel. But Elisha says, as surely as the Lord lives, and as you leave, I will not leave you. So they went down to Bethel. The company of the prophets at Bethel came out to Elisha and asked, do you know that the Lord is going to take your master from you today? He said, yes, I know. So be quiet. Blessed be the name of the Lord. You know, there is a time that you have to tell the people that are telling you already what you know to shut up. That you're not going to waste time discussing what you already know. You're not going to win anything if you put a debate. Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Amen.
You need to get to a time that anybody telling you or arguing with you on what you know, you tell them, shut up. I know. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Then Elijah said to him, stay here, Elisha. The Lord has sent me to Jericho. And he replied, let's reply together, all of us. As surely as the Lord lives and as you live, I will not leave you. So they went to
Jericho.
I love this. It's getting even much better. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The company of the prophets at Jericho went up to Elisha and asked him, do you know that the Lord is going to take your master from you today? He said, yes, I know. So be quiet. Situringe kidogo. I know.
Najua.
Be quiet.
Nyamaza.
Blessed be the name of the
Jina
Lord.
La Bwana libarikiwe.
Then Elisha said to him, stay here.
Kapa.
The Lord has sent me to Jordan.
Bwana amenituma Jordan.
And he replied, let's say together,
ebu tuseme
papa. As surely as the Lord lives, and as you leave, I will not leave you. So they, two of them walked on. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Number seven. 50 men from the company of the prophets went and stood at the distance, facing the place where Elijah and Elisha had stopped at Jordan. 50. Elijah took his cloak, rolled it up, and struck the water with it. The water divided to the right and to the left, and the two of them crossed over on dry ground. Blessed be the name of the Lord. When they had crossed, Elijah said to Elisha, tell me, what can I do for you before I'm taken from you? Without any hesitation, Elisha knew the season he was in. Without any hesitation, he said, let me inherit a double portion of your spirit. Blessed be the name of the Lord. You have asked a difficult thing, Elijah says. Yet, if you see me when I'm taken from you, it will be yours. Otherwise, it will not be. We can continue reading, but let me give you the four signs in Elisha's manifestation, which is the same signs to you. Oh, I pray that you can look at those signs, that you can be watching at those signs, because they will help you to know the season you are in. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Elisha, number one, he knew his season of manifestation. He understood his season of manifestation had come. When the prophets confirmed it three times to him that God was about to take away his master, they just confirmed it. He knew it. They confirmed it. Where there is a witness of three people, oh, that thing is affirmed. He knew for sure that God is going to bless him, because his season has come and nobody would stop him. No discouragement would stop him. No words would stop him. Not even to be praised would stop him. He never agreed to it. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
God does not do anything before he reveals this to us. He reveals it to us. He communicates to us. He affirms in our lives. Before Jesus went to heaven, he said, but when he, the Spirit of truth, comes, he will guide you. He will tell you what is to come. The Gospel of John 16, verse 13. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Elisha knew it.
Elisha akajua.
Therefore,
Ivobasi,
he followed Elijah.
Akafuata Elijah.
And he did not want anybody to tell him anything.
Na hakutaka yoyote kumwambia lolote.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Are you following the same?
Je, unanifuata?
Are you allowing people to speak into your life?
Unakubalia watu kunena
kwa? Are you stopping along the way to argue with people?
Unangojea ukaanza kubishana.
Oh, you are saying like Elisha.
Oh, unasema kama Elisha.
Shut up.
Nyamaza.
I know.
Najua.
I know my life is hid in Christ with God.
Ninajua.
I know my life.
Ninajua.
It's going to be better.
Itakuwa shamba.
Because I've trusted in this God.
Ninamwamini ya Mungu.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. I know. The second thing is, you will also know when God is just about to manifest himself and manifest you, opposition will come. Opposition will come. Now, some of the oppositions will come to hinder you to believe God for that bigger business.
makubwa.
For that greater things that he has in store for your blessed family. He wants to come and hinder you from moving to that direction. Because he knows, as long as both of you agree, you and your spouse, concerning anything, that it will come to pass, he will try to hinder that so that you don't agree. When one is saying this is north, the other one is saying this is south. But I have the story that I had one time. A very interesting story. Of these two people that had gone to Shule ya Ngumbaru. They had gone to study. They had not known how to write and so on. And they were old. This man and his wife were in the same class. And they were learning the alphabet. And so this day the teacher wanted to ask them so that he can know whether they were understanding the alphabet. And so he called the husband first and asked the husband, what letter is this? And the letter was J. No, the letter was G.
Oh, ilikuwa ile G, G.
But the husband said, Nijay.
Lakini mume akasema, hii ni Jay.
Then the teacher asked the wife,
na mke, mwalimu akauliza mke wake,
which letter is this one?
Hii ni gani?
And the wife said,
na mke akasema,
Dirona tareji.
Naona kama ni chi.
No, either wa kama uiga Nijay.
Lakini baba kama wamesema
Nijay. Demuane. Nijay.
Nijay.
That's a wise woman. If Baba Kamau says it is J, nobody else can change me. The letter is
J.
Of course, you know why she said so. Again, ukireko. So he has to make sure. If it is
J,
then it is
J.
If the Lord tells us it is
J,
whether people tell us it is G, we are going to say it is
J.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. Because he is our Savior. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Elijah tells Elisha, stay here. You see,
Elisha
knew that the Lord was going to take his master. So even the discouragement from Elijah himself, he could not budge to it. Three times he tells him, oh, don't plead with me. Far from it. Don't discourage me. I'm not staying. I'm following you. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And some prophets come.
Oh,
they were prophesying. You know, sometimes, and please forgive me. You don't have to roll in the mud for you to prophesy. No, you don't. Iyo ni upentekoto wa zamani. Kwa sababu roho anyongi mtu. Alafu anakupa neno. You getting it? Ati kwanza akunyonge. Utoke na machozi ile iko moto. Watu wa kuangalia alafu useme hivi ndivyo anasema Bwana.
Hivi ndivyo anasema Bwana.
You hearing what I'm saying?
Wasikize nisemalo.
You can just be natural as you are.
Utakuwa tu vile ulivo.
And tell somebody in the congregation.
Utamwambia mtu katika kikundi.
You lady there.
Wewe dada ulioko pale.
Stand up.
Simama.
And the lady stands.
Na hata simama.
And you tell her, Zipora. I see the Lord promoting you to an associate professor. Now, I don't have to roll down so that Dr. Zipora can realize how godly I am. So there were prophets there, the sons of the prophet. And they look at this guy and they tell him, you know, the Lord has spoken to us. Your master will be taken today. And the guy tells them, I know it. Shut up. You're wasting my time. I have something to pursue. And then another time the same prophet show up. And finally 50 of them. You know why the 50 were coming? They wanted to see what will happen at Jericho. Jordan. The Jordan River. So they are watching. There were 50. Ready to see what is going to happen. But when the water parted, I think Elisha was the first to go in. Because he wanted to see the master go. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Let me say this. Just before God manifests you, there will be opposition. People will even be asking, karate no kume kedu kega. Can something good come from karate
village?
You know, they will be asking. Can somebody who has been a house technician be married by a manager? Some people will be asking. Can a lawyer marry a standard a form 4 failure? Oh, they will be asking those things. But have you thought those to tell you? I have seen that happen. A house girl being married by a manager. Or someone who is not educated marrying an educated person. I have seen it. I have seen a house girl own a big business in this Zimmerman here. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Yani unakuta imejaa mali. Na dada mwenyewe alikuwa house help.
Alikuwa anafanya kazi ya nyumba.
Because when God manifests himself, it doesn't matter the village you come from.
Haijalishi unatoka kijiji kipi.
Tafadhali mwambie jirani yako ka village kenu kanaitago nini. Yako. Ako. Amekuambia ka village kao. Hata hako Mungu anajua.
Hata kale
Mungu. Hiyo village yenu hiyo anaijua hiyo kijiji yenu hiyo.
Hiyo village.
Anaifahamu kabisa.
Kijiji kile anakijua.
Bwana asifiwe. Praise the Lord. His mercy is endured forever. Praise the Lord. Because of his mercies, it doesn't matter what village I come from. Hey, Jao, stand up. This guy with this suit, this is my friend. This guy is a graduate of KEMU. When he went to KEMU, nobody believed he will ever even study or finish. Oh, he is a mechanic hapa Roysambu. But you see how smart he is. If Njau can go and finish his degree from Gedo, around a place where ile pombe ambayo ni ya bei inauzagwa na glass, either ujaziwe ama uwekewe nusu
kwa quota.
But this guy,
lakini huyu ndio
Gedorai 44 karibu na mto, this guy, and he's going places.
Na anaenda mahali.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
When he told his relatives that he's going to the university, they were wondering,
wadhi
gwe kate.
Unaenda kufanya nini?
No, he told the wadhi university.
Ni nani wetu
anaenda? Nendo hiyo.
Ni nani?
And this guy just went.
Na akaenda.
And the other day he graduated.
Na juzi amehitimu.
Please help me preach to someone.
Oh, nisaidie kuhubiria mtu.
Help me preach to someone.
Nisaidie kuhubiria mtu.
It does not matter what they have said about you.
Haijalishi wamesema nini.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. Your time of manifestation is showing up. Blessed be the name of the Lord. So there will be opposition. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thirdly,
Tatu.
Elijah greatly desired his master's manifestation.
Elisha akatamani akudhirisha kudhirika.
It is key for you to desire.
Ni vyema wewe kutamani.
What do you desire?
Watamani nini?
He is asked by Elijah.
Anauliza na Elijah.
Unataka nini? Wewe unataka nini? You know, a king in England.
Mfalme pale Uingereza.
Is a story, how true it is I don't know, but it is a story. It has something that I'll pass you by. One day the king decided to walk in the village and talk with the villagers. He met a lady and asked the lady, "Hey lady, what can I do for you, madam?" And the lady said, "King, live forever. If you give me an acre, 1 acre, I'll be okay." The king said, "You are request denied."
Akamwambia matakwa yako imekataliwa.
Is denied.
Imekataliwa.
He was still talking with the people.
Alikuwa bado anaongelesha watu.
Then he met another man.
Akapata mwingine.
This man said,
akamuuliza,
He asked, what can I do for you? He said, kingly forever. If you build for me a small house, one bedroom somewhere, I'll be okay. And the king said, your request is denied. Then he met one man. He asked him, what can I do for you? And he said, kingly forever. Give me half of your kingdom. And the king said, your request has been granted. Take it. Half of my kingdom. And then people started asking him, why did you not give the small things? He said, no, I have a lot. I give people who are serious, who ask for big things, because they will take care of it. What are you asking from the Lord? A bicycle.
Bicycle.
Oh my goodness.
Oh.
Did I tell you? Or maybe I didn't. I did not tell you. I did not tell him. If I was Elisha, I would do exactly what he asked. You know why? Elisha had seen Elijah being intimidated by a woman. So he says, double portion. Elijah had run away. And he was saying he wants to die. So Elisha says, double portion. So I will not desire to die. So he knew what he wanted. He was following him. Mimi sita ogopa mama. Sita kimbizwa na manabii wa Bali. Mimi nataka maradufu. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
I don't know what you desire from the Lord. In your time of manifestation, you need to desire something. Even during this conference, cause your desire and ask good things and ask big things. I know some of you know where I live. It is after I preached here that ask God for anything. Be extravagant. Even ask for the moon. And I preached here and I say, you can tell God to give you a moon in your compound. So when I went home, I'm sitting down and I'm now ninarudia ile niliwaambia. You know that's what preachers we do. And the voice is telling you, why are you serious?
By the way, ulikuwa serious pale.
Prove it.
Ebu dhihirisha.
So I told Alice, we are moving from here.
Tunahama hapa.
We have to ask for the moon.
Tuulize mwezi.
Then she asked, where is the moon? I said, I think the moon is Mudhaiga or Runda, not Kahawa Sukari. And Monday, I went around Mudhaiga and Runda. I'm telling you for sure. In Runda, I went to one house, very beautiful house. They were selling it, the bank was selling it. But the owner was inside. So when I knocked, she came out with her children. I said, Mama.
Mama.
Then she asked, no.
Nani?
I told her, ne Barclays. But of course, I could not buy that one. But because I wanted, I asked for the moon. The Lord gave it to me. Not because I had resources, but because God owns everything. Cattle on a thousand hills belong to Him. He's only waiting you to ask. Then everything else fits. So we went and saw a house where we live. And Alice liked it, and I liked it.
Alice akaipenda na mimi nikaipenda.
But we did not want to call anywhere.
Lakini hatukutaka kupiga simu.
They told us to call Nakuru, we refused.
Wakaniambia tupige Nakuru simu.
We bought some land somewhere.
Tulikuwa tumenunua shamba mahali.
At Mudhaiga North.
Pale Mudhaiga North.
But this is the miracle.
Lakini muujiza uko hapa.
When that house, we visited that house one more time.
Tulipoenda kutembea.
The people living there, the nine other homes had gotten people. But our house, the one we had entered, it was still empty. And they said, are you the one who prayed? We said, no, we don't do that. We don't possess people's things. But if it is still there, maybe it is still ours. Now, to prove God wants us to go there, I announced that I'm selling that plot in Muthaiga North on Sunday. Monday, I had a buyer. We negotiated on Monday with the same man. We did it on Tuesday with the same man. Wednesday. And this man does not know me. He put all the money I asked from him. Yote akaweka kwa account yangu. Have you gotten an account mara moja hata manager anakupigia simu? Hello. Wewe ndio kemani hii pesa ni zako. Nauliza zimetoka wapi? Eh, ni zangu. Because kama zimetoka kwa huyo ni zangu. That's how I moved there.
Ndiposa nikaenda pale.
And the miracle is not over. I stayed for about 8 months.
Nikakaa miezi minane.
I had not paid anything. They are the same people who took me to a bank for a loan. They struggled for everything. So when God wants to move you, in your time of manifestation, the desires of your heart should be bigger than what you can own. Blessed be the name of the Lord. So people who saw that, they started saying this. Bishop anakaa nyumba kubwa na iko na swimming pool na iko na vitu nyingine kule yangu haina swimming pool ni mudu akiongerea shubi
ni mtu anaweka chupi anaongezea zaidi.
But whatever it is, may your desires be known to the Lord. Because God wants to manifest you. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Usiogope. Possess it. See the Lord manifesting himself. There are some of you here that have held on to my faith. And God has lifted them to other levels. Because he's not a respecter of persons. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Desire something.
Kaize tamani kitu.
Desire something.
Kuwa na matakwa ya kitu.
Desire something.
Ukatake kitu.
One time I asked somebody here.
Nikauliza mtu hapa.
Who looked at me on a Wednesday.
Ambaye alinitazamia Jumatano. Alinitazama Jumatano.
He said you look smart.
Akasema hey umekaa poa.
Then I asked the person.
Nikamuuliza.
Do you want to be as smart as me?
Unataka kuwa smart kama
mimi. That guy was so quick. Steve, you're in the house.
Steve yuko hapa.
Huyu anaitagwa JD. JD is in the house.
JD
did not waste time.
Hakupoteza muda.
He said yes.
Akasema ndio.
And I bought him a suit.
Na nikamnunulia suit.
No, I'm not going to do it.
Sitafanya hivyo.
Sitasema hivyo, sitasema usimame. But I'm saying be ready.
Kuwa tayari.
When your manifestation time comes.
Wakati udhirisho
wako. You have something.
Una kitu.
Sio kwanza kusema godra iratu si araba. You know what you desire.
Nataka nini?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah!
Praise the Lord! His mercies endureth forever!
Rema zake zadumu milele.
Hey, help me!
Nisaidie.
Praise the Lord!
Banasifiwe.
Praise the Lord!
Zadumu milele. Banasifiwe.
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
I want to finish.
Nataka nimalize.
Finally.
Mushoe.
Elisha was manifested.
Elisha akadhihirika.
Elisha was manifested.
Akadhihirishwa
because he obeyed a condition from Elijah.
Aliweza kutii.
The condition was
akawa ameambiwa,
if you see me,
kama utaniona,
if you see me,
ukiniona,
if you see me,
ukiniona.
So I think Elisha's business was to make sure,
kwa hivyo Elisha biashara yake ikawa
ni afungi macho,
ni macho yamefunguliwa
yako wazi ili amuone anapopaa. Na Biblia inasema alipokuwa akipaa akamwangushia nguo yake.
Amen.
Na kutoka pale mtu wa Mungu akawa tofauti.
Amen.
Aliporudi Jordan tena akauliza, yuko wapi Mungu wa Elijah? Akaichapa na hiyo nguo ya Elijah na maji
yakafunguka.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
So there are four ways.
Kwa hivyo kuna mambo mengi.
And first of all, you need to know your season.
Lazima ujue wakati wako.
Because this time there are things that are going to happen to us.
Kwa sababu kuna mambo wakati huu yatatutendekea.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. But you have to know the season.
Jua
Know your season of manifestation by sensing that you are about there. Fulfill what God has asked you to do and walk in obedience, like Elisha. Overcome opposition because people will oppose you. Don't allow them to stop you. Because if they do, they will change your position. Then finally, act on your faith. Do whatever the occasion will demand in the name of Jesus. Shall we all arise in the name of the Lord? Let us stand in the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Yes, I know my season. Would you lift up your hands and tell the Lord you know your season? If you know your season, tell the Lord, I know my season. I know my time. I know there are oppositions, but I will resist them in the name of Jesus. I know my business, and there will be manifestation in my business. I know the Lord will remember me. He will expose my time. God will expose me and my business. God will make me visible. God will unveil me in the name of Jesus. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah, King of Kings, Lord of Lords.
Oh,
in this time, this week, oh God, we want to look unto you. We are focusing unto you. We are waiting unto you. Because, Lord, our season has come. We are not going to behave like it is winter when it is summer. Oh, we are not going to behave like it is rainy when it is dry. But we will know our season in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. What is your desire? What are you desiring the Lord to do? This week, tell him. Tell the Lord. Tell the Lord. Speak to the Lord. Speak to Jehovah. Tell him your desire. You have come from far. Tell him what you want him to do for you. And he will manifest you. He will manifest you. He will unveil you. He will expose you in the name of Jesus. Father,
Baba,
I want to thank you for the people that has come. Lord God, this week, you're going to do something in our hearts that forever will be grateful that we came. In the mighty name of Jesus. Because manifestation is going to take place during this time. We give you honor and we give you praise in Jesus' name.